Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to peek over my shoulder in this, what I hope to be a somewhat casual run in Call of Pripyat. And it's not the plain unmodded Call of Pripyat, it's Call of Pripyat Special Edition. I have actually started the game once before, so it's not gonna be full on new vision. But there's plenty that I haven't actually practiced in this. So there's plenty that I don't know, and plenty of entertaining blunders coming along the way. And of course it's raining! Now, I don't know if Special Edition works exactly the same way as unmodded game, but I think that I have to be wary of a blowout soon. So right now I'm trying to make my way into a shelter, and actually I know that I want to take shelter in the caves, in that hill. Uh-oh. Fucking dogs. I should probably use the flashlight at this point and see if there's a better way up to the hill. Now, thing is, I have also turned on some optional features like radioactive water, or like more radioactive water, and some weight thingies. I think it was called more realistic weight, maybe? I'm gonna try to get to a higher dry ground and then we will see about that. Also, I might need to adjust the audio a little bit more. Okay, there's a dry passage here. And I can't sprint. Okay. Woo! Are we tired yet? It's been a while since I have played Call of Pripyat in any shape or form, so I don't remember which cave entrances had anomalies in them. I think one of those that had was around here. Is there a doodad here? No. Also, I'm trying to keep a lot of the graphics at the low end because my machine is kind of on the old side, and I can't actually run many things anymore. Okay, one entrance should be around here. Swap out the old detector as well, just a good measure. I'm not gonna do any artifact hunting just right now. Wasn't there a stash there? Like in the old days. Okay, we have one cave entrance here, and I think this one's with an anomaly. Oh yes. But is it just a chemical peel, or is it also a gravity bubble? Oh, I think it's just a chemical. Okay, the gravity bubble is around here. I think this is the kind that you can trigger. Or maybe not. fancy barja down there already. Okay, I don't want to go so stupid so early. Oh, shit. Yeah, so much about that. I don't want to go full stupid so early on. Oh! I actually have my thingy in the menu. Okay, which way out? There. Now, let's see. Wasn't there another hole in this side as well? I could just drop in from the top, of course. But that's a good way to be hit with a comet. I think that's what the rotating fireballs are called. I mean, flying fireballs also. I'm very, very vulnerable right now. Okay, I think there's a clean entrance on this side somewhere. Ish. Okay, let's get into the central area fast. Okay, the comet is coming. Say I am now set for the first challenge, that is blowout. I don't know when it will be, but it's probably gonna be soon. Also, let me tone down the audio just a little bit more. Yes. Okay. Okay. We're sheltered, we're warm, aren't we, Major? And this gives me a little babble time to explain what I intend this plate to be. So, I don't intend to start up... Oh, that was a tad close, wasn't it? I don't intend to start a full-length playthrough, at least not at this moment. Because right now I already have several other games going on. I have Wasteland 2 as my quote-unquote long play of the day. And I still have some finishing touches to do in Dragonfall and in The Void. And I want to actually finish those before I start up a full-on adventure. However, I have been yearning for the zone lately. I blame some other people. I've been watching the Let's Plays of... I think there are three Let's Plays that I've been mostly watching that have given me the itch, and also I've been reading Tiger Spring, which also gives the right kind of zone itch. And I think Call of Pripyat in its free map format is kind of the right size for the sort of off again, on again gameplay. They meet over there, then they come over here. Let's suit up. Hello. Do you come here often?
Кардан алкаш старый. Как набухается, зад от стула оторвать не может. Ну так как же? Тут надо получше осмотреться. Еще и на нас шутников наехал. Молодые мы типа слишком. Ни черта не сечем. жутник тоже хорош. Обиделся, схватил рюкзак и фит с концами. Пока я кардана успокаивал, свалил в неизвестном направлении. А мне что теперь, со старым идиотом пухать? И водка это дерьмо. Тьфу ты. А так классно все начиналось.
Let's put on his suit. Is there something I don't need? Let's see, what pistol do you have? Let's keep these for the time being. Okay, where's the blowout? Also, what time is it? Oh, just past midnight. What money? Oh, Borja has some money, I guess. Okay, so a little bit more about this play's plans. I intend to do the same kind of play that I called the Zaton Foreplay back in the forum days. Meaning I am not going to head for Skotovsk at all. I am indeed going to live off the land and pick up everything and trade and train myself and gear up and obtain artifacts. And only once I have done certain things, among them achieved the mark by the zone, only then will I enter Skotovsk, and basically I'm only going to enter it to chat up with the navigator and get to Jupiter at that point. Do I have night vision? Nope, of course not. But yes, right now I'm here because it's safe, it's warm, it's sheltered. An ideal place to spend the night, really, behind all those anomalies. Also, let me check my hotkeys. Here. Night vision, yes. Okay. So medkits. This is what always seems to amuse people on my screenshots, that I have the quick slots assigned to these keys. But that's the thing. I'm used to having medkit on M, bandages on B, and now that I have radiation anti-rad on quick slot, I have assigned R to it, and T is for food items and or drink items, because that's food in my that's what the word food starts in my native language. So there's that. And throwing the weapon, I have assigned it farther away from the default from the default interact F, because I think it's been at least a few times, if not several times, when I have gotten myself killed in a radiation spot because I have dropped. Oh no, it was back in the Bloodsucker village. I went to pick up that stash in the car, and it was a radiation hotspot, and I didn't have much gear. And instead of picking up the opening up the stash, I had accidentally pressed G, which was the which was the default row weapon key, and I didn't even notice, and I ran into a bloodsucker, and I was like, why isn't it firing? And only later I found out that I had dropped my weapon there. I mean, I think the bloodsucker snuck up to me when I was emptying the stash, and everything happened at once and very fast, so I didn't really have time to check and double check anything. And I have been assigning the throw your weapon farther away from the F key ever since. So, how about that blowout now? There are probably some artifacts in here as well, but I am not even gonna try to detect them right now. And they are probably second tier artifacts anyway, so my echo won't be cutting it. Okay, let's see those comets now. Come on. Formation. Yep. Goody. That's the thing with staying out of the populated areas without night vision and without better gear, is that gets dark at night, so it's not much to show. Okay, let me get out instead. Let's see now. Has some sort of backlighting, it would seem. So Skadovsky's off the priorities list, but I could make it to Shevchenko actually. Yeah, it's right there. I could chat. Okay, better switch on the flashlight because I need to avoid water. And I don't remember this place as well as I used to. Okay, I think that's the loners lighting up my contact list. Yeah. Can't remember if there was a stash in here or not. Yoink. Insert Photoshop here. I think I have the album version of the backwater bar backwater bar image manipulation in Imgur maybe. So if I remember, I'm gonna add it to the description or something. Hello.
Слушай, все вопросы к главному.
Okay. Yep. I don't actually want to ask anybody anything right now. I just want to hang out. Because I have a hunch that the blowout is coming. Where are you going? Shouldn't you be guarding this place? So you are. Another thing that I don't know about this mod is whether they have sleeping bags here. And yet another thing relating to the sleeping bags is I don't know if there's the need to sleep. Like, for example, if Major gets blurry vision and whatnot because he hasn't slept for 2 days, then my whole Noskodov's plan falls apart unless there are sleeping bags. Hello. Oh, he doesn't even respond. Fun fact, if you drop some gear in this in these upper levels and leave the area and come back, I think the distance is like 50 meters or maybe 150. So anyway, if you cross out of the online zone and come back again, then most of the items will fall through the floors and line up on the lower deck.
Мне за хабаром сегодня плестись. Сейчас бы дома оказаться в гамачке.
Ну привет.
Да с книжкой толковой.
Вон старший стоит. Так ты к нему обращайся.
He's not standing, he's squatting. Hello.
Позбивались тут в стаи. Ну точно звери по цвету шкуры. Одни как разбойничали, так и разбойничали.
There's one mattress. Can I sleep here? What about here? I mean, I think if the sleeping bag worked here, then I'm guessing it would be in the starter inventory. Because after all, they sent Deji out here with the... What was the quote? With a weapon and the week's rations.
Attention stalkers! An emission is approaching! I repeat, an emission is approaching!
Aha! Uh-huh.
Seek cover immediately!
It's a funny thing that even when the game is set to Russian, they the first emission notice is in English. Well, if I go to the upper level so that I can see a little bit, will I still be in cover? Okay, so I won't be in cover here, but I will be in here. I don't want to do the demo record thing. I don't like that. Okay, I am covered here. Ooh, goody.
Вот дерьмо-то, а. День коту под хвост катится. Ни хабара, никакого...
Oh, where are you No, don't push me. Where is he going? He's gonna die. are they going? Oh, is he coming up the stairs too? No. Okay. Oh, it could be that these loners here have plot armor. Okay, my vitals are still okay. Guys are totally blasé about it. Are falling out of the sky. Okay, manual save here. Let's just overwrite the old saves and let's see what has come to pass. What about the patrolling guy? Is he still around? Oh, there are the birds. And of course it's still raining. Why wouldn't it? Huh. So he is. Of course, since Call of Pripyat doesn't have this easy, hard, off again, on again button, I can't really check the body count as easily. Or I mean the body map. Bodies on the map. Yep, he's alright. Hey, yo. Of course, because of the drafts, I suppose this is like this is explainable. Not an actual plot hole. Okay. Now I want to go out wandering, and I think one priority would be to obtain a better detector. What time is it? Oh, it's still night time, so if I come up with any stalkers, they would just have to be camping out here. And somehow I think that so early in the game I won't be running into people just wandering about at night and getting caught by blowout. I mean, later when there's more population, then that might happen, but not right now. Stay out of water. So yeah, the priorities list goes like this. I need a better detector. so that I could find some better artifacts. And I need better artifacts to be able to carry around more doodad. Because, as we all know, doodad is life. Am I hungry already? No? I don't know. That's another downside to the hodless operation, is that can't tell so easily when hunger strikes. So yes, priority 1, detector, priority 2, artifacts, priority 3, gobble up gear. I will be needing all sorts of supplies. I will be needing ammo, food, everything. I intend to get all that by looking up on various stashes and of course good old corpse looting. Conclusively say that this campsite is abandoned. I need to go to higher ground if I want to see if there are any campfires around. Why not the high route? Also, I'm not going to pick up stuff from the convoy because that's hard. That's like heavy, yo. And I think I need the key anyway, so. Just for good measure. Take the wild guess that this one particular bandage is still stuck in stone. Also, I probably shouldn't go to this area because bloodsuckers are known to hang out here. And I'm kind of underprepared for them right now. Safe out there, I think. Yeah. Gonna leave it alone. Can't remember if there were any stashes up here as well. I know during my original foreplay play, I was trying to find all the stashes on my own without any hints or rewards, and I think I was able to find like 40, or like near 40, but the others said that there was near 50 maybe. So even though I thought I looked everywhere, especially into places that that follow the "this is where I would stash something," I know that there were at least a handful of stashes that I didn't get. Close to the plant can I go without being pestered? I think I can go into the guard booth with no problem, but once I actually cross over into the area proper, that's when the mercs start bitching. Hello, show me your documents, please. This is one of those higher ground points where you might be able to get up there with a grenade jump, but might not. I can't remember if I have been able to jump to this higher section here earlier, but it's very possible that there's an invisible wall over there. I mean, I know some invisible walls have been put in quite absurd places in here. So how can I tell if I'm hungry? I mean, I could just eat like 3 square meals a day. Oh! Different descriptions. So this is like normal bandage, and this is... Ah! New bandage. Oh, improved bandage, okay. Good to know. I know there's stash in that truck. Can I go in? Whoop whoop. I'm just minding my own business here. Never you mind. Yoink. I'm very inconspicuous. I'm like totally invisible, yo. Oh, hello. Oh, shit, snorks. Yeah, I think I'm better off running, actually. Also, I think I'm better off waiting for the results in a safe-ish... Can I get up there? Okay, so the snork is hunting the piggies, I take it? Yeah, snorks are hunting the piggies. Okay, so there is... Okay, go. Shit, water. Oh, fuck. Get off. I need to get out of the water. Fuck. Yeah, I know.
Сталкер, вали отсюда, пока ноги не повыдергали.
Shut up, I'm trying to. Okay, that wasn't very elegant. I was actually hoping to loot for some pork, but... Okay, that might still work. Also, when the whole Snorkhunt's piggy was going down, I heard a gravitational anomaly clap, so I'm not sure if they ran into it or what. Oh, okay, they ran into the one on the bridge. Gimme. Yeehaw. Stealing the goodies straight out of the Snork's mouth. I was never even here. Okay, is there a ladder here? Yeah, let me get to higher ground because Snorks. So I have some extra I want to say a rather way. Okay. No. Dope. Okay. No more stupid. I wanted to drag it here actually. Time is it? No, yeah, time. Okay, it's almost morning. Oh, we have. Oh, okay, that's the cleared stash. Never mind. Yeah, these pipes here were one of those stuff where I would put some stuff. Okay, I don't want to cross the bridge right now. I actually just want to go to the circle. Where's the ladder? Here. So, I want to go to the circle anomaly, not piss off any more marks on the way. The side here. What's that under the bush? Oh, it's just anomaly blurring my vision, I think. Get past it fast. There is one very easy way to infiltrate the plant, and I don't mean the quest pipe. When there is a blowout, then all the mercs are gathering into one room, and it is possible to move about quite freely while they're doing that. Hello? Okay, while I'm here, I might as well snatch myself some grenades. Are we hungry yet? And how can I tell? Because right now, until I have more supplies, I don't want to spend spend or use up any of my supplies more than strictly necessary. Here? Was it here? Yeah. Okay, so that was the whole stash. Oh, there's more. Does it count as two stashes then? Was there anything else? I'm not sure. Okay, is there anybody at this site? Nope. Well, none other than the glorious pyro geist, I think was the folk name. Okay, I'm not gonna approach these guys either because they are going to ask for food, which I don't have, so... Nuh-uh. I will, however, approach this campsite and see what might be happening here. Also, in this area here, between the circle and the whatever this one was called, can't remember. This seems to be one area where the stray artifacts are found sometimes, maybe. I mean, I think I have picked up at least three low-end artifacts from this hill alone. One of them was Snowflake, I think? No, not Snowflake. What's the cheap version? Sparkler? Crackler? It has been a while. Oh, there's stash here. Yoink! Show me the descriptions. Oh, okay. These are the same. Oh, and I'm actually pretty well endowed when it comes to ammo. Not complaining. Can I pick up anything with this detector? Although I might not be rat protected enough to poke here just yet. Yeah, it's too weak. Alright, the sun is coming up. I would hope to see more people soon-ish. Can't remember if there was a stash in this car. Oh! No. If there was a stash in this car, but I don't want to get irradiated, so... Not gonna check it just yet. I used to have this little habit of taking screenshots of Shevchenko in every possible angle. Oh, gunfight! They're playing my song in every possible angle and light and weather. It's like the I don't remember the number, 32 prints of Mount Fuji. Okay, I think we should eat now. That was easy. At the rock, yes. Okay, one way to get at D detector would be to go to... Whoa, go to the two dudes at the burner. No, I don't remember what the condition was to get, like, better reward. Was it so that if you already had a bear and you saved them, then they would give you a fireball? Or was it the other way around, that when you already had a fireball, then they would give you a bear? I always mix these up. Hello. Dogs? Pseudo dogs, fuck. I feel so raw and vulnerable and noobish right now. So I don't want to waste ammo on blind dogs, not unless I have to. Because what's happening there? Okay, for a pseudo dog, I can spare a bullet. Missing, so I was just pissed off. Hello, doggy. Damn. Yeah, my aim is all off and reaction ain't no better. Is not to fall down. Oh, there's two of them. Wouldn't it be fun if they attack each other? If one of them is wounded and the others smell blood or something? Aim for the ass. Well, that was lame, and totally my own fault too. See you in a sec. So, this is where I saved last, huh? Okay. So, where do I want to go? I'm not going to the Emerald City then. I'm gonna cross over here, and I'm going to hang out near the ships, so that I can catch the stalkers when they wake up and come out to play. Also, I probably shouldn't try to save ammo while I'm in my vulnerable noob state. any stashes on this little thingy. Easy. So even though I'm gonna stay off Skadovsk proper, it doesn't mean that I can't hang out near Skadovsk. Okay, I think we can shake that little rat off. So the main thing with water is not to stick around, even if I step into water. Just keep moving. Of course there are pseudodogs there as well. Piggy! Okay, so what time is it now? Oh, almost 8. I mean, close enough to 8. I think at 8 o'clock the stalkers start moving, unless it was 9. Easy now. When I see a squad, I'm gonna ask them to take me with them. Oh, boars, of course. Can I get up this boulder? Don't think so. I'm gonna try. Oh, damn it. Oh, close enough, I suppose. I don't wanna go there either. I just wanna hang out in the vicinity and catch the crows as they come out. Oh well, I'm gonna need to wait a little bit. Anyway, since I almost kinda survived the night, I think this is a good place to end the episode and start anew. So, thank you very much for joining me on this casual stroll. See you soon, and bye bye.